In this video, I am going to explain three important nerves of posterior side of hip joint. I'm going to talk about three nerves today. One is this one. This one is the biggest nerve in human body. This is sciatic nerve. You see this one, another yellow one. This one is inferior gluteal nerve. Inferior gluteal nerve. And this yellow and green striped one is superior gluteal nerve. So, sciatic nerve, inferior gluteal nerve, and superior gluteal nerve. First thing first, I'm going to talk about why I'm going to talk these three nerves. Why? Because you see this beige tape? This one represents piriformis. You know, this is very important for hip joint. This is piriformis. These three nerves are very close to piriformis, right? You see? Inferior gluteal nerve, very close to piriformis. Sciatic nerve, very close to piriformis. Superior gluteal nerve, also very close to piriformis, right? Then, I'm going to talk about sciatic nerve. Again, sciatic nerve shows up from inferior border of piriformis here. You see that? And go down, 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 down. You see these colorful tapes? These tapes represent lateral rotators of hip joint. Actually, piriformis is one of deep rotators. Then these colorful tape represent also a lateral rotators. Sciatic nerve runs posterior to these lateral rotators. Then go down, 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 down. So if piriformis or lateral rotators get tight, it can compress sciatic nerve. Because of that, it can create sciatica, sciatic pain, right? And this goes down, 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 down. You don't see in this video, but sciatic nerve has relationship with hamstrings and adductors. So sciatic nerve has so many relationship with hip muscles and the posterior side of thigh. What if piriformis or lateral rotator gets tight? It can create sciatica, maybe numbness on the posterior side of thigh, or muscle dysfunction of lower limb. Why? Because sciatic nerve or related nerves innervate so many muscles of lower limb. Sciatic nerve, very important. One more nerve which has a relationship with inferior part of piriformis. What is this one? This one is inferior gluteal nerve, right? Inferior gluteal nerve runs like this diagonally. This nerve innervates gluteus maximus. You know, gluteus maximus is the one of the biggest muscles in human body. It runs like this, covers whole posterior part of hip joint, right? Very strong muscle. So, inferior gluteal nerve innervates gluteus maximus. And this one, this nerve, is superior gluteal nerve, runs like this. Same like inferior gluteal nerve, runs diagonally. This nerve innervates three muscles. The one is gluteus minimus, the smallest gluteus muscle, right? We had gluteus maximus, the biggest one. But this one is innervated by inferior gluteal nerve. Gluteus minimus is innervated by this one, superior gluteal nerve. Another gluteus muscle is innervated by this. That is gluteus medius, the middle size of gluteal muscle, gluteus medius. And one more muscle is kind of anterior here. The last one is tensor fascia lata. It's located on anterior side of pelvis. Again, superior gluteal nerve innervates gluteus minimus, gluteus medius, and tensor fascia lata. Again, these three nerves have relationship with piriformis. So when piriformis gets tight, it can have effect on these three nerves. And these three nerves are very important for hip muscles and maybe a lower limb. So I hope this video helps your understanding of anatomy structure. So this is it. If you liked today's video, please like, comment, and subscribe. See you in next video.